right now?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm George Mizanin.
Hello, I'm Barbara.
We're Michael's parents. The WWE.
Great job, Dad. Great job.
Okay?
Yep.
I'm George.
Hi, Barbara.
We're the parents of the WWE. The
Mike
Miz.
The Miz.
Thanks. The WWE.
Mike the Miz. We're the parents of Mike the Miz.
Yeah. I'm George.
Hi, Barbara. And we are the parents of Mike the Miz.
That's good.
Okay.
Very good.
To let you guys know exactly just how my parents are, my mom thinks I've never done anything wrong in my entire life, that I am perfect.
It takes an exceptional person to prove everyone wrong.
This is champion!
And I did just that.
Are you proud of me?
You're my Michael.
My father, on the other hand.
I always thought he was kind of average. Never expected this to happen with him, ever. I mean, I've been surprised my whole life with him.
Thanks, Dad.
What?
That was special.
I've been average my entire life. No.
Michael was a very active child. He was the biggest ham.
Michael. Hey, have I been good or not?
Stop time.
Trying to steal the show, whether he was a child, a teenager, or as Mike the Miz, he always steals the show.
Look at that bow tie. Look at that handsome little devil, huh? Karate, yeah, black belt.
Really dedicated himself to everything that he liked.
Michael was a perfectionist and very competitive.
Basketball was his sport.
I thought he was just an average player, but he tried hard.
He was on varsity.
He weren't a superstar.
I was pretty good. I mean, I was captain of the baseball team.
Yes, but you never played.
I played. I was a pitcher. You don't play every game when you're a pitcher.
Wow.
He is not average. He's way above average.
Thank you, Mom.
Your first day of school, you were so excited to go to school. You liked school, you wanted to get up. You could never be late for school.
When he was a teenager, that's when he really got into wrestling, and he'd have all his friends come over every Sunday for the pay-per-views. And that's where you...
Pay-per-views.
Pay-per-view. Okay.
The Mega Power! Explode! Here at WrestleMania 5!
I went to WrestleMania in Atlanta City. So on the way home on the plane, I signed some autographs and gave it to Mike. He took it to show and tell.
8 years old, my dad signs autographs. No one knew that it was my dad. And I didn't even know it was my dad until I opened it again and looked at the autographs and I realized that was my dad's handwriting and my dad conned me. Conned his 8-year-old son into believing that Randy Savage, Hulk Hogan, and Honky Tonk Man all signed his program at WrestleMania 5.
Pretty good, huh?
Of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Normandy High School was my backbone. It was kind of the place that taught me you can be anything. Like, I loved high school. I was president of student government. I gave such a speech that my dad actually helped me with. And because I told him the speech, and he was like, you shouldn't do that. You should do it like this. And then I did that speech, and I won. I became student government president.
If you are not in a winner's spot, you should be in attendance. Please see Mr. Bramwell with any questions.
And the Miz is here, right here, the Miz.
To everyone out there, do your homework, get straight A's, and have as much fun as possible. It's Normandy High School, and you guys are awesome!
Now in there is our basketball court where I played basketball. I wasn't the best, but I did try the hardest. I remember my dad sitting in the stands yelling at our coach. Have him tell you about the time that he yelled at the coach and what happened the next year.
The coach is making all these bad decisions and I'm yelling. The coach turned around and looked at me and said, would you like to run the team? I said, absolutely. He says, come on down. So I came down there and he kicked me out of the game.
Next year, your tryouts, what happened?
Michael got cut from the team because the coach didn't like me.
Right now we are at my dad's Mr. Hero on Ridge and Denison. And this was my first job. I was legit flipping burgers on that grill, putting fries down, wafer fries, which are the best.
He did whatever he wanted to. I didn't really care. I mean, it was like I wanted him to have some good work habits. That wasn't his forte. He didn't like the restaurant business. He won what?
I was your hardest worker.
I'm surprised you even knew how to cook.
Nobody better than me. Nobody faster.
6 years.
Yeah, I flipped burgers. You're acting like I fell asleep the entire time. Kidding me?
You quit.
I ran that. What do you mean I quit? I went to college.
Gotta say, I haven't lost my touch.
So after the real world, I was like, what do you want, Mike? What do you want to do with your life?
His main thing in life, he always talked about, was WWE, being a wrestler.
It's a Mizanin family tradition, if you will. Christmas Eve party, and they got me this. And so it kind of gave me motivation to, like, it gave me a thing where, like, that's where I want to be, where my family's behind me.
Never in my wildest dreams did I ever think he would succeed, and I thought he was too small, but tough enough. That was a shocker of my life.
Hoorah, baby, step into my reality.
But with the Tough Enough, went to every library. I passed out about probably 50,000 flyers because it was online voting.
And so she kind of cheated to let him win.
No, I did not cheat.
She was supporting him
50, all the way, 100%. That's not cheating.
Okay, never mind.
But for me.
Then when he went into WWE, I sat there and thought, you know, he's living his dream right now, and that's good.
It was like so surreal.
I am the future. The face of this company.
You could see he had talent. Well, I remember his first action figure. Oh my God, I went crazy. That was probably one of the most exciting things. My kid has an action figure.
I can tell you which my most memorable of them is. My dad laughing while I'm getting my ass handed to me by Randy Orton.
That was hilarious. I wasn't laughing, I just didn't know what to do. I mean, that's kind of embarrassing when somebody's beating your kid up in front of you and putting him in front of you, and I'm saying, what are you supposed to do?
Not laugh?
Randy Orton has blown a gasket.
From Cleveland, Ohio,
The Miz.
Main event at WrestleMania, it was huge. I couldn't believe it, very proud. That's when I met The Rock, and I met his mother, and it was like Michael was got mad at me because I forgot about him for a minute, okay?
When you were backstage at the Hall of Fame, and what I told you not to do.
Oh, pictures. I was in the picture-taking mode, and I was taking pictures of everybody, and I wasn't—
Were you asking to take a picture of him?
No, I was just taking pictures.
So Michael had to take his camera away.
Meanwhile, I told him not to take pictures with people because they're working.
I got a bunch of pictures of Rock, his mother, family. It was fun.
Yeah, where's that? Where's there he is?
Right over there, the
Mrs. Dad. There he is.
I'm a born entertainer. I enjoy being in front of the camera. I enjoy entertaining the audiences worldwide each and every week.
The prodigal son of Cleveland, The Miz.
He's done very, very well for himself. I mean, with the WWE, never in a million years would I think he would be where he's at today.
I am proud of the man that he has become. He's not average.
You applied yourself, worked at it, and you're doing very, very well. You're far above average now. Now you're a superstar. Now you're one of the best, I think. The difference between Mike and The Miz, they're almost complete opposites. Mike is really a low-key guy. The Miz is conceited, complete opposites, I think.
You are in basically my mom's shrine room of Mike as well as The Miz, AKA, as she likes to call me, my Michael.
The Miz is a character he created. My Michael is humble, he's kind, he's generous. And always will be. And he'll always be my Michael.
Give it up for my parents, Cleveland!
Is that a wrap?